Jesus, Yeshua the Christ, bless each and every one of the lovers of truth. All right, I'm going to try to keep this brief. And so I welcome you all. I thank you for tuning in on today. If you have been listening for some time, you know that this is more than likely one of those shares that I did not want to share, right? But in willful obedience, meaning that I have submitted my will to his will, I am here to share this with you, all right? So God bless you all. Now, I wasn't really sure how to come to bring this out, all right, because I could name this a number of things. You know, I wanted to deal with the misogynist issue, meaning men who hate women, but I really want to just allow the Holy Spirit to lead me, and I really felt that he wanted to talk about men who need to know how to express their women, express their love towards women. If you're interested in marrying a woman, you need to get your emotions in check. You need to know how to communicate. You need to surround yourself with godly counsel. All right, so we'll discuss that in the share. But I want to give you an example of someone whose emotions got out of whack, and as a result, it ruined his life and the life of the woman that he loved or thought he loved, all right? And so I'm not going to read it all for time's sake. Let's go to 2 Samuel chapter 13. And in 2 Samuel chapter 13, I want you to go back and read this. It's the account of Absalom, Tamar, and Amnon. Now, they're all brothers and sisters. They have the same father but different mothers, okay? And the account goes to, let's just read this. First one, it says, and it came to pass after this that Absalom, the son of David, had a fair sister, meaning a beautiful sister, whose name was Tamar, and Amnon, the son of David, loved her. All right? So Amnon falls in love with his half-sister, Tamar. Okay? And Amnon was so vexed that he fell sick for his sister Tamar, for she was a virgin, and Amnon thought it hard for him to do anything to her. All right? But Amnon had a friend whose name was Jonadab, who actually was his first cousin. All right? And it says that the son of Shimeah, David's brother, and Jonadab was a very subtle man, meaning he was very cunning, just like the serpent of old. The Bible tells us that the serpent was very subtle, very cunning, knew how to get his point across in a subtle way. And so, to long story short, Amnon ended up listening to Jonadab. Jonadab said to him, you know, how is it that every time I come to see you, you being the king's son, you know, why is it that you're growing lean? You know, because from day to day, the scripture says, and he said unto him, for why are you being the king's son lean from day to day? So he's growing lean. He's losing weight. He can't sleep. He's staying up all night. You know, he's not eating. He's in love. Okay, so he thinks. And so this goes on for some time because the scripture says from day to day. For you to end up losing weight and all this other stuff, that means that this emotion that he had may have started out as love, but it has been suppressed for so long, and he's never dealt with this emotion, and he's obviously never talked to anyone about it. And so the adversary, Satan, always has someone for you to talk to. Unless you surround yourself with godly people, he will always send someone to whisper in your ear, someone who's subtle, someone who's cunning, who will lead you in the wrong way. And this is what happened with Amnon. So Jonadab advises him to lie to his father David and to tell his father that he's sick, and so ask his father King David to allow his sister Tamar to come over and to feed him and to take care of him. And so David agrees to this, and Tamar goes over to what she believes to be to take care of her brother. But when she gets there, what does he do? He throws himself on her, and she begins to say to him that he should not do this. She says, no, my brother, don't force me, for no such thing ought to be done in Israel. Do not this folly. And I, where should you cause my shame to go? And as for you, you will be as one of the fools in Israel. She went on to say, let me ask the king, or let us speak to the king, or you speak to the king. He will not withhold me from you. But the scripture says that he would not hear her voice, but being stronger than she was, he forced himself on her. And after he raped her, the next verse says that, and Amnon hated her exceedingly, so that he hated her more than he loved her before. So the hatred that he now had, or that was manifesting now, was greater than the love that he had from the beginning. All right. And so he ends up telling his servant to throw her out, to lock the door. And she's outside the door with her virgin garment. She tore it and she, you know, just began to wail and cry because of what just happened. Now, her brother Absalom took account of this and he told her not to say anything, and he kept it for him to himself. And I believe it was 2 years that he waited to get his revenge on his brother, and he ended up killing Amnon. So see, because Amnon didn't deal with his emotions, it took him to a far place. It even took him to his grave, all right? And it ruined Tamar's life. It tore a family apart. It caused the whole family to get off course. But as I've said in another share, but because Amnon chose to listen to the advice of Jonadab, Jonadab was really the one that pushed this thing over the edge. He saw the weakness in Amnon and played on that weakness, as the scripture says, because he was subtle. And that's what the enemy will do to you and is doing to a lot of men who don't know how to deal with their emotions. Their love that they're having is turning into hatred. And that's why it's so important for men to have good, godly counsel in their lives. Because if you don't deal with your emotions, your love that you have for someone can turn to hatred because you feel that the person has rejected you and they don't even know that you are in love with them. And if you are in love with a woman, if you're a godly man, you're ready to get married, you really need to seek godly counsel. You need to surround yourself with men and women who can advise you in the way in which you should go. All right. I really don't believe, this is my personal belief, that a man who's ready to marry should really put that on the back burner for a long time. Okay. Don't jump into marriage. Don't choose any woman, because there's nothing worse than marrying the wrong woman. Okay. I think worse than marrying the wrong man is marrying the wrong woman. Okay. But if you are a man who is rooted and grounded in truth, you are maturing in the things of God, because we're all still continuing to mature. But you, when you get to the point when you know you're ready to marry, you need to do something about it quick and in a hurry. All right. I thank God that he has, you know, good people in my life, and I have people who are family and friends, and some of them who are not biological family. But I was, for example, I was speaking to one of them this week, and I know, and I knew for some time that he was ready to get married. He's still a virgin. He was, and he's a, you know, man's man, real man. But let me tell you something, men, women can sniff out, and not only men, but women, people can sniff out good people. Okay. It's just something about them. They can tell. All right. And so he's been telling me about this woman, you know, who keeps, you know, at work, who keeps hugging him and, you know, wanting to kiss him on his cheek. And I told him, I said, you know, you need to get that in check. You need to deal with that. Okay. Because see, you're at the point where you are looking for marriage. Okay. You're not looking for lust. And then at the same time, you have this physical thing going on where you're desiring to express your love to your wife in a physical way. All right. So you have to really get those emotions in check, because if not, Satan will always send you someone. All right. So please deal with that and get godly counsel. If you are a man that's ready to get married, you need to ask God, okay, Lord, help me to find. When Abraham went to get a wife for Isaac, he used his right hand man. Okay. He consulted with his right hand man and he told him, don't have my son marry a woman from any other place. I want you to go and get a wife from, you know, and he told him from his family where to go and get a wife for his son Isaac. And then he advised his right-hand man, who was also a spiritual man, because you see, when he went to get the wife for Isaac, he sat down and he prayed and he told the Lord, he said, okay, in prayer, this is what I want the person to do. So you need to have people in your life who are people of prayer, who can assist you. Don't try to go and make a decision about a wife or a husband on your own. Okay. And I think the Lord will have me to deal with that in another share, because that's something else that's been brewing for about 2 weeks. Okay. God willing, I'll deal with that in another share. But in this share, I want to say, men, it's very important to have godly counsel in your life. It's very important to deal with your emotions, because if you don't deal with your emotions, the love that you have can turn to hatred. You can begin to feel feelings of rejection for a woman who doesn't even know that you care about her. Seriously. And that's how misogynists come about. Men who begin to hate women because they develop in their mind and in their thought some feelings of rejection. Perhaps they have been rejected and they haven't dealt with that rejection. And so they begin to build up those feelings of resentment and rejection and bitterness and hatred. And the next thing you know, they feel that way about all women, or they feel that way about women of a certain whatever, okay, segment of the population. So men, deal with your emotions. Emotions are not just for women. It's something that men deal with. And you will find, like in the account of Amnon, unless you deal with your emotions, what you thought was love over a period of time has turned to hatred. Okay. And so for whatever reason, Amnon refused to express his emotions to his family or to anyone. And even when his sister Tamar said, go and talk to the king, he still refused to do that. There was some sort of blockage there that made him not want to talk with anyone. Had he made that decision to talk with someone before he tried to force Tamar, or even at the point where she pleaded with him that he go and speak with someone, his life would have been spared. Amen. Maybe that entire family would not have experienced what they experienced because he would have made the right decision. Amen. So I encourage you, first of all, if you don't know Jesus, then you can't make these kind of decisions. If you don't know him as your Lord and Savior, you need Yeshua to direct you by his Spirit to lead you and guide you. The scripture says that husbands, love your wives as Christ loves the church. Okay. You can't love your wife as Christ loves the church if you don't know Christ. Amen. And you don't know his love for his church. So you need to seek him for guidance. You need to seek him for as your personal Lord and Savior. And when you are found of him, then you need to ask him to direct you in the area of marriage. Amen. Because you do not want to make a mistake in marriage. Like I said, worse than marrying the wrong man, I think, is marrying the wrong woman. And I say that because women are designed to, in most cases, to endure more, to be that helpmeet. Amen. And they're there to submit to their husbands. And so it's easier, not necessarily easier, but that willingness to endure is greater in women, I think, than in men. So it's very important for you men to choose the right wife. Okay. Choose the right wife. And allow the Holy Spirit to help you and seek godly counsel in choosing that wife. Yeah, I really do believe that. You need that godly counsel. All right. So God bless you all. And thank you for tuning in. I may have some scriptures in the description box for you to refer to. And there may be more. Have a wonderful afternoon, evening, morning, whenever you're hearing this. In the Lord and Savior Jesus, Yeshua the Christ.